I owe you everything.
No, you don't. I'm sorry I couldn't save your sister.
I was there. It wasn't your fault.
I was paid to protect her, and I didn't.
She married into a sick family.
Maybe.
I just wanted to say thank you for giving us a chance to live. I mean, as a family.
I hope it all works out for you, for all of you.
Thank you. Don't be too long.
Well, buddy, that's it.
Where are you guys gonna go?
I don't know, maybe back to New York, maybe down to Argentina. Giovanna has family in Salvador. Maybe we'll just stay there.
Yeah, I got business to take care of.
I'm sorry I dragged you into this. I know it was very wrong.
It's all right, it's done. And hey, I'm having myself a fun old time. Maybe this is how things had to be. Figure I might as well die in the sunshine as die in the snow.
Look, I'm sorry I'm leaving. I got a kid coming. You know how it is.
I know how that is.
You know, I almost didn't say goodbye to you. I said to myself, maybe this guy will put a bullet in me.
Maybe I will. But not right now.
Thank you. Try to look after yourself, Max, huh? Life is worth living.
If you say so, pal.
I thought I was going to have to witness another murder.
Nah. Not him.
You ready?
I guess.
Okay. I've looked through this information you gathered. It's not very nice.
What is it?
It's the Ufe. The famous Mr. Becker.
Friend of Victor Bronco.
Yes. And a contributor to his campaigns. A government employee, of course.
And?
A weapons dealer. A murderer. This was known. A dealer in human organs. This wasn't known.
A proper gentleman.
Sure.
So you're gonna bring him down?
Yes, because I want to lose my wife and my children and then get killed myself. All that after watching him walk free.
Tell me what has to be done.
Well, officially, there's nothing I can do.
And unofficially?
Well, we can always try something a little more creative.
Creative? De Silva had promised me a 10 o'clock showcase. I had to make sure I was on stage and ready for my close-up.
Hey, what are you doing here? Huh? I ask you a question.
Answer him. Answer him.
What are you doing?
What?
What are you doing here?
O que você está fazendo aqui?
What are you doing here?
I don't understand. I can't hear you.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Hit me in the ear.
Hey, answer me. What are you doing here?
Back in the precinct after all this time. Time to find out what the hell was going on. Drug squad had a few habits of its own. I guess our little stunt helped some other civic-minded people raise valid concerns about community relations. Their faces said it all. I was on their side, but how could they know that? If they came through that door, I believe it was a human shield and never leave them at all.
for me, for once the police arrived just in time. It sounded like all hell was breaking loose. Whatever nonsense De Silva had pulled, it seemed to be working. It was time to leave this. The last few prisoners were trapped in here, and more presently, it seemed I was too. Friend I had left in that town. It was Monday's arrest log, as far as I could tell, and no sign of anybody from Nova Esperanza. All those poor bastards have been checked straight into the Imperial Palace Hotel. Kid had had the right idea. There was no point bouncing bullets off that thing. I decided I'd try to pick up where he left off. Shame to let that RPG go to waste. Isn't this nice? The perfect end to a perfect trip. If someone had told me 6 months ago this was where my life was headed, I'd have ordered a double of whatever they were drinking, drunk it, then blown my head off.
Porra, você tá tentando fazer?
Quebra as pernas dele! Cadê seu respeito? Não estamos...
Another dark, rainy night. Another police station. Another futile crusade for amends. Time moves forward, and nothing changes. Come from the control room. It looked like the security cameras were still running. I figured I should check out the security monitors while I had the chance. It looked like the prisoners were giving them a run for their money. That's what happens when you hand some roided-up halfwit a commando uniform with special on the front and let him ride around his hometown in a tank playing soldiers. Sooner or later, someone's gonna decide he's not so special. There were a bunch more in the elevator, tooled up like they were about to roll into Fallujah. And of course, they were headed my way.
Thank you.
If the heat was rising, that meant I was getting closer to the source. I had to keep moving. Starting to feel as if I'd never leave that place. Like one of those nightmares where you keep running and running, only to discover you're chasing yourself. Tear gas. This wasn't good. I needed to find a way out of that stairwell and fast. That would have been too easy. My eyes and throat burned, but at least I could breathe. I was trying to work out what direction I was headed in when I discovered some more Brazilian architecture not designed for the American physique. There it was, the tape from the Bronco security system. Jesus, it was that guy. I had seen him in the favela, Bachmeier, Becker's right-hand man. His time would come, him and Becker.
Gringo de merda.
I don't think we've been properly introduced.
I know who you are.
And you should have killed me in the office when you had the chance.
There's still time, meu camarada.
Tá cego, porra! camarada! Bate de frente aqui, professor!
Another pile of bodies and still nothing to show for it. It felt like I was detaching, that maybe this was revenge for something else, something buried deep in the past. Rodrigo, Giovanna, Passos, everyone who'd meant anything was gone. Like so many times before, I'd found myself alone, locked on a course of destruction. It was at my worst when I was at my best. Becker and Bachmeier had taken their pound of flesh and sold it on the black market. Now I was coming for mine.
Esperando a confirmação do outro grupo, mas o gringo já deve estar morto agora.
Senhor, ele não parece estar morto!
Da puta, pelo amor de Deus!
Americans love to interfere in things you do not understand.
Oh, I understand plenty, asshole.
How stupid can one man be?
Thank you.
This was the passkey to Becker's office. I was close to the end of all this, and I could feel it.
Becker!
Something funny about dying?
I felt like the avenging angel. I looked like a fat, bald dude with a bad temper.
You disgusting piece of shit! I know everything!
Not everything, my friend. Let go of him, Max.
Huh?
There's a good fellow.
Well, well, well. Victor, I was wondering when you'd reappear out of whatever slimy hole you live in.
I'd like to just say, Max, I just want to say thank you for all your hard work, for my family, and for cleaning up that horrible mess with the Crachá Preto for us. You know I'm tough on crime. I give you a bonus, but I think you just frittered it away. Becker, take his gun.
Toma, seu filho da puta!
They had barred the door. My only hope was to chase them down. I knew they'd be leaving town, and my guess is they would try to fly out of here. Rich people love to fly away.
God damn it!